I'm Shraddha. I'm an orthodontist, entrepreneur, influencer, and podcaster.
Hi, I'm Ridhima.
I'm Deepya Ahuja, and currently I produce podcasts for HT Smartcast, Hindustan Times podcasting leg. Most of the people whom I met, the feedback that they were giving me was that there's something that's holding me back from working with people, from opening up to other people. And so I entered a therapist's office for behavioral correction. Believe it or not, that's how I entered.
So the first time I realized that I'm having a mental health issue was because of my friend, because she was the one who brought, who highlighted this to me, that the number of my anxiety attacks, my panic attacks have increased and that I need professional help.
Now, my first bout with mental health issues was when I was 9 years old. Of course, at the time, I didn't realize what I was going through, but as I grew older and I learned to recognize feelings, and as I read up more, I realized what I had been going through at that age.
Either people, you know, people around you, either they would put you on a pedestal and they would be like, oh, you've still done such amazing things with your life and, you know, we're so proud of you despite the mental illness, you worked this hard and that hard. And, well, you know, the appreciation and the validation, no one is, you know, complaining about that. But what happens is that by doing that, you're also putting a lot of expectations on a person who's already, you know, going through something difficult in their lives.
The most difficult part is the journey from denial to acceptance, and how our past or childhood related memories have an impact on our present and future life, if not resolved.
The most difficult part is the feeling of numbness. Now, I'm lucky that I don't constantly deal with mental health issues. It comes once in a few years, but when it does, it stays for a while. And the thing with numbness is that it creeps up on you slowly.
I started taking things more maturely, more gracefully. I started applying, a lot of tools that I'd learned in therapy outside of myself and outside of my universe also, and that made things a lot easier with friends and family and at workplace.
My mental peace is extremely important for myself, and it is my responsibility that I take care of it.
Well, the first step is to accept it, and of course, for that, I have to recognize it. So recognition and acceptance is step one. Step two is reaching out. I have people who I feel safe with that I can talk to, and I reach out to them and I try to explain to them what I'm feeling, and a lot of them are able to help me and help me. Even by just listening to me, they're able to help me.